What we were looking at was, what is quality assurance? So quality assurance is making sure that with this infrastructure as the background and the software that is built works as expected. And what's expected? As per the business requirements, as per the business owner who has worked with the business analyst and mandated, this is what I want. So role of quality assurance is to make sure that the system works as expected. So how do they do their role? They would do validation and verification, right? So validation will be whatever is the requirement, they are correct, right? Now the system is expected to be built in which they say that 100,000 users can be served from the infrastructure. The 100,000 users are never going to be concurrently active. Is the requirement correct? The requirement itself is not correct on that, right? Because you're looking at a small application in which you have local office people who are going to work on that application. Why would you have that kind of requirement? Because if you have that kind of requirement, your cost of support for infrastructure, cost of development, everything goes up. So validation of the requirements has to be done, right? Then when the system is built, you verify the requirement. My application, when a user has attempted 3 times to log into the system with incorrect details, he should be blocked. That's a requirement. You will verify that, right? So validation and verification are two important techniques that you need to use as a QA resource to certify that the application works as expected. Right? Make sense? So that's the QA role that you have in the application. How do we execute that role? How does that QA team get formed? What are the roles of various team members in the entire group? How will I be a part of that group? What will be my career path? How will I grow in that path? All these things we'll cover up in a little moment from now. Right? So this big infrastructure, do you have any concerns on this, what we are looking at this point? Do you need any other understanding of this big infrastructure that we are looking at?
How much application?
So what happens is there are some pre-existing solutions. For example, there may be a shopping cart that is required for your application. So instead of building that application on your own, you could plug in a third-party service provider or a third-party application that can be a part of your solution. For example, when you go buy something on Macy's.com, do you have any other option to make a payment other than Macy's card?
PayPal or...
PayPal, very good example. And?
Even MasterCard.
Visa, Master, any other card service provider can be used.
Mm-hmm.
Do we write code for that every time? No. All we do is just call their service and ask them, this is a MasterCard that I am expecting a payment. So we just make a call, tell them, this is a MasterCard, this is the amount, tell me, is it charged? That's it, you don't do anything else. So similarly, there are functions and features that can be plugged into your application architecture which are built on these services here, which are specialized services, right? You do not write a shipping program, you just transfer the shipping request to UPS, DHL, USPS, they take care of it, everything, right? So if you want an application for e-commerce, you don't have to worry about writing a logistics program. You just need to partner with them, provide them information as they need it in their system. They'll provide you hooks in their application, and your application will work seamlessly. Right? Make sense? Now, when we look at these various components in the application infrastructure, we will have quality assurance needs at each level. And when you start working on this, there are specialized tools that you will be able to use for different aspects of quality assurance. Now what we're going to do is walk you through the software development lifecycle. The software development lifecycle Yes, who is that? Hi, who is that? Okay, all right. So what I'm showing you now is the high level software development life cycle. Now in software development life cycle, what is software development life cycle? From the beginning of the request, from concept to delivery of the finished product, that when you start breaking it down into various components, that's what is your software development life cycle. So if you look at this here, the first highlighted object that you have towards the left of your screen is giving you a breakdown of the so-called master project plan, in which you will have requirements. What is requirement?
What does the client want?
Your name firstly. Okay, so Praveena says requirements is basically
the client needs
the information or the content the client shares with you, which is requesting the system that they need to build. So that's your requirement. Your requirement can be, I will allow a valid user to access the system. If the user has attempted 3 times with invalid detail, he has to start, or she has to start, not gender bias. The user will have to restart a session to try again. If the user has tried 3 times, he will be blocked for the day. A user will not be allowed to create an email address with the ID that already exists. These are all requirements in a system. Have you tried creating a new ID on your mail service provider with the same ID? It doesn't work. Because the requirement set that as a background. The development team developed it on the basis of that. The QA team validated it. And finally, when it was rolled out to production, the actual application that has that feature. So requirements is nothing but the guidelines or the basis on which the application will be built. Right? The next segment that we're looking at is feasibility analysis. What is feasibility analysis? That's basically making sure that what is required can be done. After that, we're looking at design. Now we start working on creating the framework for the application. Now the framework of the application will be, what will the screen look like? How will the technology support? Do I need Java? Do I need .NET? Do I need HTML? Do I need ColdFusion? What database do I need to use? What type of bandwidth do I need to get connected with? So that's all the design work. After design is done, then you start building the application. Building the application is a part of development team. The development team will have developers. They will have junior developers, senior developers, architect level people. Right? We'll be working on that. And once the application is kind of built, then you start testing. Right? That's where the quality assurance team comes into play. There are various roles. Now, once the application is tested, then you're ready to go live. When the application goes live, what happens? Big celebration. Yay! All right. But with those celebrations come some responsibilities as well. Now, the responsibility is that you listen for the problem the customer has. So you will look at issues that are post-production. Right? You'll maintain those. You will have enhancements that will be requested in the system. And then once you have met the lifespan of the system, it could be that the technology has become redundant. The business is itself wound up. Business has moved on to a different area. For example, you were working on client-server application earlier, now you're going to be revenue. So whatever are the systems that you have, they may sunset because there's no more life in that system. Which is the sunset phase. So all this is basically your software development lifecycle. So try and read about software development lifecycle on Wikipedia. That's another question, which is a hint. What is software development lifecycle? So software development lifecycle is nothing but going through the stages that we've just discussed here. And you can go into large number of details at each step. depending on what is your area of interest. So what we're going to focus on is the testing and quality assurance aspect of the software development lifecycle in this training program. So testing and quality assurance begins right from step one when the requirements are being drafted. So what is the various activities that we do? First, we will identify the scope of testing. Now, scope of testing can be various options that you're looking at here. It can be regression, function, stress, performance, load. There's a lot more that you have here, which is basically nothing else but types of testing. So that's the next question. What are the various types of testing that will be executed on an application? You could also be going into validation testing, which is you validate your requirements. But are these correct? Are these requirements workable or not? Are these requirements feasible? All that will be done in the scope of testing itself. Regression. These are a few important things that have been highlighted here, but there's a lot more types of testing that you need to do. So what is regression? Regression is you get the application, you start working on testing it, and you find some defects in it. What do you do with the defects? You have to fix it. But when the defects get fixed and a new version is delivered to you, what do you do then? You test only the new ones or you test the old ones as well?
The existing ones are
the existing that were passed earlier and the new ones that have been delivered to you. You will have to do a test on everything. That's what is called regression testing. So you regress on what was passed earlier. So let's say there were 10 test cases. Of those 10 test cases, 2 failed and 8 passed. So when the next build comes in, you will not just test the 2 that are fixed, but you will also test the other 8 that was given to you, which was working fine. And why do you want to do that? Everything works as expected. That's the most important aspect of quality assurance, right? So regression testing is to retest everything that was previously certified as testing with the new build, right? Okay, so what is functional testing? Online team members. Yeah, who is this?
This is Priya.
Yes, Priya, go ahead.
Yeah, functional testing is, I mean, what are all the functions in the application, we are testing those functions.
Okay, the features and functions, when they get tested, that's what is functional testing. Now, okay. For example, you are testing security of the application. The security of the application can be done by opening the app, providing user ID, providing password, and clicking submit. You can change the values that you use for user ID. User ID and password can be different, right? So a function is a set of steps that can be executed by varying data. You're still doing the same thing. When you want to test, user number 1 can access, user number 2 can access, user number 3 cannot access. All you're doing is doing the same steps, but you're changing the data in the steps. That's what is called functional testing. And of course, it functions as expected. Right?
So for example, if I'm going to withdraw cash.